It's trying to get the, it's trying to verify that the stream is working here. And sure enough. Alright. So, again, this is just like a one more kind of test. I mean, call me crazy, but I just want to make sure that everything is perfect when I do my live streams. I know it doesn't matter that much, probably, as far as some of these things are concerned, but I don't know. I'm a dentist. I'm very kind of particular about things, and I think a lot of dentists are like that as well. So test, but again, I'm gonna try to also do what I was planning on doing anyway, which is right above me, stream goals. If I have to do it a couple times, that's fine. Again, I'm just trying to test things out. So, forgot. Let's get my background music on. I'm also curious if that will prevent the stream from actually happening or not, because that did with Twitch. But, I mean, it truly is just for background, and the artist is playing below. So credit goes to them. And we'll get going. I definitely have something very, very cool coming up here. I just bought a new piece of, I guess you can call it hardware. Yeah, it's hardware. It's also software as well, but it's amazing. I think people are going to freak out. And I'm pretty sure this company knows that, because they're only marketing it to like streamers and YouTubers and things like that. But this thing, it's amazing. I'm going to do a separate video on that soon. I guess I'll just tell you, it doesn't matter. It's called the, by Elgato, the Stream Deck. This thing is unreal. Okay, fine. Now I'll actually just show you, if I can. So it's like a little LCD panel. Each one of those things are different buttons, and they just run certain macros, commands, open websites, play sounds, start things. So it's literally amazing. For this, it's in particular very amazing. I can also see how maybe your receptionist, they have four or five different programs that they use or different things that they always do. Just have this sitting right next to them and press a couple buttons. It's automated. It's really powerful too. And I think it has an API, which makes it even more powerful. Okay, so the first goal we have up there, I'm actually just going to see if I can, again, testing things, but with this Stream Deck, you can also kind of iterate through different scenes in OBS, which is this program I'm using to stream. So let me, try that, and then bingo bango, just like that. Look at that. That's so cool, just by button press. Anyway, so the first thing we're trying to do is using the virtual vacuum former to do a Waxup matrix. I don't know if this is the right one. This is not the right model to use this for, but I guess we can make it that way. So, and I guess with the also with the virtual vacuum former, this doesn't need to be a solid model, so we don't have to do model builder or anything like that. But let's at least get it kind of oriented. Okay, let's say. Okay, let's just say this tooth. Actually, I'm trying to look at the laterals and see which one looks more natural. That one still has the mamelon on it, so I'm just gonna go with that. And we're gonna say this tooth. This one is the one that we're gonna be working with. I'm gonna hit go first. This object browser basically kills me. But with this Stream Deck, I'll show you. Man, this thing's so cool. I can go to, I've made a pre-made hotkey template for Mesh Mixer. And it's got almost every tool on there. So if I want to get rid of the object browser with a button press, like that, like that, like that, easy. If I want to view the print bread, the print bed, I can. Button press, wireframe. This thing is, it's just unreal. Okay, so now back to what we were talking about. This tooth, I'm gonna see if I can get wax up here by deleting this tooth or virtual extracting it. I gotta admit that this is going pretty slow right now. I think it's because I'm trying to do. I'm definitely not trying to record this time, but I'm streaming it at the 1080p or 1080 HD or 1080p. I don't know. 920 by 1080. That's what I'm trying to stream, and I could dial it down if I need to, which I'm probably gonna end up doing, but. Okay, let's get rid of some of this. And actually, I don't even need to use a keyboard because I have this. Selection tools. And I want to. Come on, work. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Decrease the size. This probably would have been a better one to do a different selection method on. I mean, this is just fine, but if you're doing this a lot, I'm sure this would be fairly annoying to do it this way. You can just draw a line around it, and that's probably easier. But, okay, that looks good. I'm just gonna go to my Stream Deck. Let's see here. I wanna optimize that a couple times. And then I want to smooth the boundary. And then I want to discard and fill. I don't have these organized perfectly yet, but discard fill, oops. Dude, unreal. Okay, that's fine for now. And so let's just say that this was the model that was presented to us, and it's like, oh, you have to do a wax up, or I guess even more accurately. Oops. It's like a peg lateral kind of. Yeah, I gotta optimize this setup better, but. And that's our pig lateral. Great. Well, you know what? I probably. Okay. Well, I probably would have to do a virtual extraction. Actually, no, I'm going to keep it there. I'm going to keep it there. So we're going to mirror this tooth here. So what we need to do first is select it, and we'll do it this other lasso way this time. That doesn't look good. This guy right here. Is that a hole? Hitting the inspector, and it's only what? Oh yeah, just one. So that's not a hole in there. Lasso. I think the next thing I need to learn is the that 3D space mouse thing. I have one, and I've had it for like a year, but oh great, there's a retainer on here. I played around with it at first, and I don't know. It's definitely something you're gonna have to like at least. My first initial quick impression was it's something that you're gonna have to like really commit to, and then that's gonna be the thing that you use from then on out, like consistently. Like, it was that much of a difference for me, but then again, I just kind of barely messed with it. Oh no. That messed up that selection. Action Bronson. Hilarious. From New York. My dental school alma mater. Shit, man. Okay, don't use the lasso, because that's ridiculous, apparently. I guarantee you it's because of this stuff right here. Now that I'm doing it this way, I think a better way probably would have been to get rid of that retainer first by just kind of deleting it, deleting it out of the mesh, and then doing this whole selection thing, but whatever. Optimize, I'm gonna grow it by one ring. Ah, damn, look at that. And I should not be saying, damn, I'm sorry about that. Some of that out of here. I'm holding control down. right, so that's good. Optimize, smooth border. Separate that. Copy it. Bring this one back into that one. We're gonna combine. Close cracks after this is done. And now that separated part is now effectively back in there. I know it looks like it's not because there's the border there, but it, excuse me, but it's because this one's overlaying it. So if I get rid of that, you'll see that, or actually more like this, like it is back to normal again. But I want to only deal with this. Ay, ay, ay. A little bit of a mess here. When I do that, up the smoothness and down the preserve shape, it just makes that line even smoother. I'm gonna hit accept. God, that thing's killing me. Okay, I guess I'll wait till I make it an actual. Exact same thing, and erase and fill. Kind of see how many repetitive tasks there are here, so it's good to have something like D3Mesh or this Stream Deck going, and that will be good. That's what I should have done to begin with. clear selection, but now we're gonna make this, we're gonna fill in the inner proximal, I guess, is the best way to say that. So I'll go, kind of grab this area. And then I'm going to optimize, and then, what is it, bridge? I think it's control B, or maybe it's just B. It is, no shit. Cancel. It is control B. Accept. You're like, that doesn't look that great. Well, increase it, optimize. Smooth. Ooh, gross. Max smoothness. Accept. And then come in here, double click one of the triangles selecting the border. Oops, try that again. Picks the whole ring. Select a little bit more, optimize, smooth boundary, and then we will F, which is discard and fill. Jeez Louise almighty. I don't know if we should have done that, actually. I'm going to cancel that, because that's way different. Let's go inspector, and then we'll do a smooth fill there. Yeah, it's better. Then I could have done that the other way too, the way I was doing it, but again, afterthought. So that side's done. Kind of grab this part here. Decent amount. And a similar amount on this side. Gonna optimize. This may not. And then control B. You don't have to increase the refine, but I did. I don't know why. So that looks good. Increase the same thing, optimize, and then we'll go control F for smooth, and we'll go max smoothness, accept, and this time I'll show you without using the inspector how to do this. You just want to select one triangle that is selecting the border like we did. Oh, geez. Okay. Jeez. So the reason that wasn't working is because I was clicking on this triangle, but there's a couple more that are actually in there that I couldn't see. Okay, so there you go. We have that selected. I'm going to go optimize and then do that same erase and fill, but instead of selecting a lot, I just do just the border. And that's way better. Except. There you go. So then, let's see. What's the best way to do this? Do I make this solid first? Okay, so I'm just bringing this original model up so we can do the mirroring process. I have the tooth selected, that guy underneath there. And we'll go edit, mirror. And this just mirrors that object, so I'm going to kind of drag it over a little bit. If you actually have this aligned well, then it should just be a matter of dragging it over, which I didn't really try to do, but it's looking pretty good. You can see that there's a little bit of the extrusion there. So I guess it's a matter of keeping the incisal height, which I'm not sure is even, let's bring that. Oh, I don't think that, I was gonna say, see if I could bring that down, but let's just do that. And at this point, we actually don't need this part, so we're gonna delete that. So it's just this one, bring that back up again. Now, to get rid of this, you could either do it, let's copy this first. What's that thing? Yep, that's the pig lateral that we made. So, I guess, if you're doing a wax up, then you'd have to kind of buzz off that part, or... bring it... like, out a little bit more. But, yeah, we'll do that. No, we're not. I like the where it's at and approximately better that way. So one way is that you could just bring this down a little bit. And there you go. But, oof. That is way lower, so we're not going to do that. Cancel. So the other way would be, it's easier to visualize it when you like this. I'm gonna do the select tool, make my brush a little bit bigger. I'm kinda just gonna select this whole area, a little bit erring on the side of the bottom, or the more gingival aspect. I still want the anatomy of the original tooth involved in the calculation of smoothing this out here. But you do want to include anything that looks like it's got that straight edge there. Go like this, kind of just finish that off. I hope this is enough, that looks okay. optimize. And now we'll smooth it. So it should be kind of smoothing that part, kind of going in a little bit. Let's try max smooth and see what that looks like. That's fine. Except clear. That was the original one. I don't know if it looks actually much better in that comparison, but. And it's kind of misleading to see the face groups there, so let's do this. Go select everything and control shift G. Gets rid of the face groups. So I think that worked, you know. I mean, definitely smoothed out that area where it's interfacing the gingiva there. Now that we have that in place, oh man, it just looked like the contact still looks weird there. Okay, we'll try to. Actually, there is a little gap there on that one too. Hopefully I didn't just mess everything up. And really, this is not even the point of this at all, so God knows why I'm even doing this. Tilted in, but those are not the right. It's that moment where you just should stop doing what you're doing. Does look a little bit worse. It looks like kind of fat now. But I think it's because of that. This area right here. Okay, we're just gonna say that's good because this could go on forever. So that looks good. And now we have to make that part of the model, but this is an open model, so that's gonna be okay, we'll try we'll try it this way. So if I double click on this other model with the selection tool selected, and then I wait, it should select everything that that object is touching. So if I oh no, I didn't want to do it that way. I want to go like this, like that, and then select and double click on this tooth, not on the model but on the other one. Double click, wait for it to finish, and now we can hide that, and it shows everywhere that that tooth or that wax up was touching. So I'm gonna, again, I've never done this before, but I'm just kind of going, doing it as I go. I'm gonna optimize border again. And I think I'm gonna also select that as well. Optimize, do the border again, smooth border. And let's, when in doubt, copy your model so then you don't ruin stuff. Okay. Come back here. And we will, I'm going to try to select that. Delete it. And then come to this guy, and I'll do the reverse. I'll select okay, and then I'll unhide this one. Touching, I guess. It's not working out as good as I thought. Oh shit, that's even worse. Ew. That's why. Wrong model. Let's do, that's why I made a copy of this. Same thing, select, double click the other model, wait for a second. And then we're gonna, once that's done, hide the other model. That still is weird. But let's try increasing. That works. And then if I optimize, maybe? Actually, I'm going to do one more increase. Optimize. Get rid of this part. Delete that. So now we have the tooth shell, which is open. And then we have the model, which is open. And try to connect those two meshes. At least that's the idea. Let's go to the tooth, and I think that it's too closely overlapping. Ay, 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 look at that. Okay, so now there's like a little bit of a gap there, and I think this, oh man, is there a gap there too? Yes. Let's get rid of some of this, these little, you know, it's so funny because, right, I did all that interproximal stuff, basically, looks like for nothing. But this is part of the, this is, you know, this is why I'm doing this. And I don't do it next time. So anyway, we'll go get rid of that so I can get rid of these little flappy things here. Come on. Select everything, do the smooth border again, so we got a nice smooth edge there. I'm starting to think I might even, but we'll wait for that. We'll wait for that just in case I don't need to do that. Bring this back. Okay, that's a, like this stuff isn't good. You know what, fuck it, let's just try it. So what we're going to do is we're going to combine these two models together, even though they're not even close to being connected. They just need to be in the same, kind of the same object, I guess. And let's select both border rings. So I should select, yeah, kind of two areas that we want to stitch together. I'm gonna increase that just a little bit, optimize. I'm also gonna smooth it. I honestly don't know if that makes any difference at all. Might make the calculation not work, might make it more difficult, I don't know, but it just looks aesthetically better to me, so that's the only reason I do it. Now I have those two edges selected, and I'm gonna do, I think it's just J for join. It, we're going to accept. There you go. So it's part of that model now. We didn't have to do any weird Boolean stuff. It does look funny with the face group, so we're just going to go select all. And Control Shift G. You know, it's not perfect, but for Waxup, for this, which I wasn't even trying to do, like how you're supposed to do a Waxup, it's nothing to do with that whatsoever, but there it is, mirrored tooth, or I could have put, you know, tooth library tooth in there, which probably would have been, I don't know if it would have been easier actually, to be honest. I kind of like the mirrored thing. Anyway, so we got this now, so we can finally do our first goal, which is the dry run wax up. We have our model, we waxed it up, that tooth, and let's go next. Trying to get some soundboard buttons lined up here. Alright, Mesh Mixer, this one's for you.
It's time to kick ass and chew bubble gum, and I'm all out of gum.
That's right. In fact,
let God sort him out. Come get some. Come get some.
Come on, Mesh Mixer, come get some.
Come get some.
Oops, didn't mean to do that one, but there you go. Could you imagine having this hooked up to your speakers in your office and like someone comes in, assistant, and they're like, hey, this patient is refusing x-rays. Can you please come in and help me out? I'd just be like, button.
This really pisses me off. This really pisses me off.
Damn, that was annoying.
Oh man, there's just so many things. Or, on the flip side, assistant comes in and says, hey, a patient refuses x-rays. But I went over the standard of care and they have agreed to now take the x-rays. I just want to let you know that that's a concern that they had when they came in. Then I'd be like,
I appreciate that. You smart. You loyal. Betty, you smart. You very smart.
Fact.
Matter of fact, you a genius.
Genius. Boom. Done and done. You got the whole hallway cracking up, puts people in a good mood. And it's true.
I appreciate that.
I do, man. Because you already know I'm going to have that same conversation. I'm not going to say anything differently. It's going to be the same exact thing. You might as well just do it. And if they're gonna say no, then probably not gonna be able to see him, so it's also something that you know. So when people do that, take the initiative, love it. Okay, we're gonna draw the appliance outline here. What am I doing? This is for a wax up, so I'm gonna reset the outline. I don't need that. This is the tooth that we're gonna be making a matrix for here. So let's go a few teeth over this way. I don't even know. No, reset outline. I don't need to do that at all. Don't know why I'm doing that. Actually, let's go canine to canine. I think that's a good idea. I'm gonna come below onto the gingiva. Watch out for that thing. still going to use a lot of the palette here for retention, so this thing stays on. Why? One more time. Okay, so that will be our little matrix. We don't want any impression gap. The appliance thickness can be 1 millimeter, that's totally fine. All my songs have run out, so it's just playing some random stuff. Okay, so how do I go to my history? Go to the very end of it. Oops. When I was going to my history, I was looking at the first page, and I'm like, this isn't, but it was in reverse. I know, I'm stupid. Let's do this. Can we just play this? How come it's not letting me play it? I have to do this for each one? No. What if I can like select all? Oh my gosh, that would be horrible. I wonder if I can enter a playlist in. Oh, here's our stuff. Cool stops now. I don't know if you can hear, but my cat is clawing at the door trying to get in, like howling. But trust me, it's so much worse when she's in here. She's just walking on the keyboards and messing stuff up, and it just drives me crazy. Maybe on the next stream I'll let her in and I'll show you. It's horrible.
Damn, that was annoying.
That was meant for my cat, but... Yes, looks like everything's working. Okay. So, there you go. There's a little matrix that you can use to, and I would print this in indirect bonding tray. And you can do like a injection mold. So with that, you're probably gonna want to, I haven't really thought about this. I think you could just print this out and you could make your own adjustments with your handpiece, but let's just check this out and see what we can do. So there's actually kind of a cool tool here that I can't even remember where it's at. Let me see if I can remember. Not here. Maybe it's with a selection. Tube handle. Okay, so you need two different surfaces. So that's the outside, and then on the inside, optimize, smooth boundary, and that's done that for both of them. And now, I think if I go, yes, tube handle, refine, that just makes it, I don't know, in this case it doesn't really matter, a bit more accurate. Except bingo bango, look at that. So now I can put my my carpule, my compule, or I use Activa, and it has it's like a flowable type, like what is that, but like bioactive type of composite, but it really works well. It looks good, it holds up well, releases fluoride, all that good stuff. But the best part is it's got this little tip that you could easily insert into this, and that would just fill it up and over that pig lateral, and it would basically just do that entire wax up for you. However, if you did that, you'll notice that you would definitely bond those two teeth together, or those three teeth together. So I'm gonna try something else that I typically do with my handpiece or a scalpel, but I'll try it this way. I'm just gonna draw straight through the inner proximal here. I've never tried this. I don't know if this would work, but we're going to optimize, smooth the border there, or the boundary. And I guess I should have done that on the other side too. Okay, that's fine. It's got a face group now, so I can always double click it. Which one was it? It was on that side. So here, we'll do the same thing. Optimize, smooth the boundary, got that, and now I'm gonna also select this, should have them both selected. Let's try that same thing, let's go tube handle, brilliant. To that border, and I guess I could extend that out as well, but let's try this. Again, this is proof of concept, never tried it, but I'm just, and I, but I will. I just haven't got around to it yet. I'm too busy doing this other stuff. So I'm gonna do the same thing here. I'm gonna select all of this. You know, it's actually kind of too bad. Sometimes I get so carried away of trying to get this stuff done that I don't actually get to use my own products. Optimize, smooth boundary. So we have that. I'm gonna double click on this one. We'll do that tube handle. I'm gonna hit optimize, I'm gonna hit remesh. I'm gonna do relative. The reason I do that is because if there's any, like, you see this pink part right here? Like, I'm wondering if maybe, just maybe, there was like some weird triangles going on there, intersecting or inverted. But if you remesh relative, it almost always fixes that. It kind of just like is a fudge tool. So just to be safe, I'm gonna do that. And same thing over here. Optimize, remesh, relative 0%, accept. And select everything. Control shift G. Get rid of those spacers. Okay. Man, this would be righteous if this worked. So you just slide this on. Oops. Actually, fart. I did the wrong tooth. This all should have been done for this tooth. But I'm definitely not going to redo that right now. That's the concept, though. Holy crap. So all of this would be on this tooth right here. And underneath it would be that little pig lateral. I do have it right there. It's the pig lateral. Let's see if I can just to visualize it better. There it is. And then I guess I didn't finish my thought here. However, the whole purpose of doing this is, a la Corey Glenn, he did this a long, long time ago. Same thing. He didn't print out the matrix, though. He did an Essex or something like that, sucked down, but drilled a little hole. He did scalpels in between each interproximal, and then you can place a little piece of matrix material in between the contacts, so then that won't, or plumber's tape or Teflon tape, that would work too. You could just wrap it around the adjacent teeth, so it kind of still have that contact there. Man, I can't wait to try this. So cool. Anyway, that's that. And this took way longer than I thought to do this first part, which is the Waxup matrix, but this is how I would do it. I'm gonna try to automate some of these other steps, you know, at some point down the line, but this is how you do it manually. You do get to generate the shell, though, and you could, if you wanted to, just do that matrix and then adjust this clinically once it's printed out. So, or Corey Glenn method, you could just wax this up, print it out as a model, do a suck down matrix, and then scalpel, drill a hole, and cure through the matrix. So anyway, that's that. In proper computer science of dentistry fashion, if you haven't seen my CE course yet, this is a one of the things that I use when we get done with an achievement. So we have done this first goal. Thank God it's done. And yeah, we can move on to the next one, which is a flipper base. But we're not going to do that right now, because I'm too tired, actually. Or at least I need a break. So there's that. Awesome. Hopefully this worked out well. Hopefully everything sounds good.